Hello everyone, welcome back to Chunda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a bralette. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And for this top, it is available for size small until size extra large. Okay, now let's get into the video. First thing first, we are going to make the bra cup. For this bra cup, it is for size small and size medium. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 16. It is equal 3 inches length. If you want your bra cup bigger, please add more chains. For this foundation chains, it is about 2.8 inches. It's almost 3 inches. When we start to crochet the stitch, it will become 3 inches. And this is the measurement for size large and size extra large. If you guys want to make it bigger, you can add like 1/2 inches. Next, we are going to make the lemon peel stitch. To begin, for row 1, skip 1 chain and we are going to make single crochet into the second chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. After you have made a single crochet, then we are going to make double crochet into the next stitch. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Next, we are going to alternate single crochet and double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. So after you have made a double crochet, then make a single crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then make a double crochet into the next stitch. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what the first row of lemon peel stitch looks like. So if the last stitch of your row ends with a single crochet, for your next row, we'll be start with a double crochet. Like I said, we are going to alternate single crochet with double crochet. So for row 2, chain 2, it is for double crochet stitch. Turn your work and make a double crochet stitch into the stitch near chain 2. Keep in mind that chain 2 or chain 1 doesn't count as a stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then make single crochet. Keep alternating single crochet with double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back in. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the second row looks like. So for the last stitch, we end with double crochet. And for the next row, we are going to start with a single crochet. So chain 1 for single crochet, turn your work, and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Then keep making lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, for the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 11. It is equals 3 inches length. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 11. For the measurement from row 1 until row 11, it is equals 3 inches. For you guys that make it bigger, please add more rows. Or you can follow the measurement that I show on the screen. So you should have a little square. It is okay if the height of the square is a little bit longer or a little bit shorter. And next, we are going to make the bottom part of the cup. So for the small square, it is the upper part of the cup. To begin, start from row 11, or you can count row number 1. You have to chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have one last stitch. And we are going to increase into that last stitch by make 3 stitches into the same loop. So after you have made a double crochet, then make a single crochet into that last stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then make a double crochet. After you have made a double crochet, then make a single crochet. In total, you must have 3 stitches in the same loop. Next, we are going to continue make lemon peel stitch into the side. And this is the stitch or the loop of your row. I know it looks a little bit confusing, but when you actually making it and you can see the stitch or the loop where you can insert the hook through. And this is the last stitch of your row. For this little small loop, it doesn't count as a stitch. And this is what the cup should look like. For this pointy part, it is the upper part of the cup. And for this row, it is the bottom part of the cup. You guys can use stitch marker to mark at this first row of the bottom cup. It is easy to know and to start counting the number of your row at the bottom cup. Next, for row 2, we are going to alternate the single crochet with double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Thank you. for the next row, keep making lumen pill stitch until you reach row 13. It is equal 3 inches length. If you guys want the cup longer, please add more rows. You can try your cup on your breast to see it fit perfectly on your breast. And this is what your cup looks like after you reach row 13. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. But for the second side, at the bottom part of the cup, we made 14 rows. You can see this is the little square. And this is the first row of the bottom part. The stitches look a little bit confusing to count the number of the row. So you can see this straight line and this straight line. For both lines, we count as 2 rows. So 2, 2, 2, and 2. And for the second cup, I have 14 rows at the bottom part. You guys can choose any size of the cup. For me, I choose this line that have the short strand of yarn to face outside. And I repeat the same thing to the other cup too. As you can see, the first cup that we made only 13 rows at the bottom. It is a little bit shorter than the second cup. Don't worry, we are going to connecting both cups by continuing from the second cup and add one more row to the first cup. To begin, continue from your second cup, from the cup that have 14 rows, and we are going to make the bulk crochet 2 together. As you can see, the last row of my second cup and with the bulk crochet. And for my first cup, it start with a single crochet. So I have to make the double crochet on top of the single crochet. It means that we can make two double crochet near with each other. So I have to remove this last stitch and we are going to make the double crochet 2 together. To make the double crochet 2 together, yarn over, insert the hook into the last loop of your second cup and continue insert the hook into the first loop of the other cup. Yarn over, pull through these 2 loops. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And this is how we made the bulk crochet 2 together. But if my last row end with a double crochet, it means that I have to make single crochet on top of it. So I'm gonna show you how to make single crochet 2 together. To make single crochet 2 together, insert the hook into the last loop of your second cup. Then continue insert the hook into the first loop of the other cup. Yarn over, pull through the loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. And this is how we made single crochet 2 together. So I'm gonna remove it and make my double crochet 2 together again. And then continue make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what your both cup looks like after we have connected the cup together. Next, we are going to make the bottom part of the top. So the part that we connecting the cup, I'm not count as the first row. I count it as the row 14 of the cup. So for the bottom part of this top, I also use lemon peel stitch the same. And this is the row that I count as the first row. Please keep making lemon peel stitch until you reach row 4, then I will meet you back again. And this is what your top looks like after you reach row 4. Next, for row 5, chain 2. Turn your work and skip the small loop near chain 2 and make the bulk crochet into the next stitch. So for this chain 2, we also count as a stitch. Then chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make the bulk crochet into the next 2 stitches. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make the bulk crochet into the next 2 stitches until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Next, for row 6, chain 1, turn your work and we are going to make single crochet into the bulk crochet stitch and into the chain 1 space until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 7 until row 10, we are going to make lemon peel stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you got 4 rows of lemon peel stitch, then for row 11, we are going to repeat the same thing like row 5. And for row 12 and row 13, we are going to make single crochet for 2 rows. Next, we are going to make the back part of the top. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is and chain 1. Then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the second row of your bottom cap, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. as you can see, this is the first row of your bottom cup that I told you guys to use stitch marker to mark it. And this is the second row, and I'm gonna end my row from here. Next, start from row 2 until row 13, we are going to make lemon peel stitch. It is equal 4 inches length. If you guys want it longer, please add more rows. And this is what the back part looks like after you reach row 18. Next, we are going to make the holes for insert the lace through. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is for row 19, chain 3. Turn your work. Skip 2 stitches. And make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. After you got 5 stitches of single crochet, then chain 2, skip 2 stitches, and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side by touch the yarn from the corner and make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the second row of your cup like we did in the first side. Remember, make sure that both sides have the same number of the stitches and the same number of the rows. Thank you. And this is what your top looks like after you finish the back part. Next, we are going to crochet the border around this upper part of the cup. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner, which is where the underarm part. And chain one. Then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the V-shaped part. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the V-shaped part, then we are going to make increase by make 3 single crochet into the same stitch. After you got 3 stitches into the same loop, then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach row 13 of the bottom cup. Then I will meet you back again. As you can see, this is the row 14 of your bottom cup, and we are not going to make single crochet into this loop. Skip this middle part, chain 1, and we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side by make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the V part, then make increase, and then continue make single crochet until you reach the corner part, which is where the underarm part. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the next stitch. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work. Skip one stitch and make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the V part of the cup, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the V part of the cup, then chain 2. and we are going to make half the bokeh shade into the next stitch. To make half the bokeh shade, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Next, chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make half the bokeh shade into the next stitch. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make half the bokeh shade into the next stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the middle part of your cup. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 2 last stitches from this middle part, then we are going to skip these 2 stitches and skip this chain 1 space. Chain 1 and we also skip 2 stitches of the other size cup and make half the bokeh shade into the 3rd stitch. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing by chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make half the bokeh shade into the next stitch until you reach the V part, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like. Make sure that both sides have the same number of this half the bokeh shade stitch. Next, we are going to chain 2 like we did at the other side cup. And then continue make single crochet until you reach the corner part, which is where the underarm part. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the strap for the top. Make sure that you're working on the right side of the top. To begin, insert the hook into the 2nd stitch of the V part. And make 232 chains. If you guys want it longer, please add more chains. Next, for row 1, we are going to make half the bokeh shade. To begin, skip 2 chains and make half the bokeh shade into the 3rd chain. After you have made a half the bokeh shade, then chain 1, skip 1 chain and make half the bokeh shade into the next 2 chains. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 chain and make half the bokeh shade into the next 2 chains. Until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. So I'm gonna skip these two chains and add the chain one here. Then continue make single crochet into the next stitch. Next, keep making single crochet into this half double crochet stitch and into this chain one space until you got 5 stitches of single crochet. Then I will meet you back again. After you got 5 stitches of single crochet, then we are going to make the peacock stitch. To make peacock stitch, chain 3. After you got 3 chains, then skip 2 chains and make slip stitch into the first chain. Turn your chain and you can see the small bump, and we are going to make slip stitch into it. And this is what the peacock stitch looks like. Next, make single crochet into the next 5 stitches and we are going to make peacock stitch again. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make single crochet into the chain one space and into the half double crochet stitch. And now you got 3 stitches of single crochet, then we are going to make the peacock stitch. After you have made a peacock stitch, then keep repeating by make 5 single crochet and then make peacock stitch until you reach the V-shaped part, and I will meet you back again. And this is what your top looks like after you have made a peacock stitch. Make sure that both sides have the same number of the peacock stitch. Next, after you reach the V part, then continue make 230 chains. And we are going to repeat the same thing like we did in the first strap. After you reach the end of the row, then continue make 2 chains and make slip stitch into the next stitch. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. Thank you. Next, we are going to make the peacock stitch at the bottom part of the top. Make sure that you're working on the right side of the top. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Then make 5 single crochets. After you have made 5 single crochets, then make peacock stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And now your bralette is done, and I will show you how I attach the bra pad into this bralette in the next video. If you guys love this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.